Hello there, very good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London and George Bennett is joining us once again today from Rainbow Rare Earths because you've unveiled an updated technical report detailing how you will economically extract rare earth from your phosphogypsum stacks there in South Africa. So we'll go through all the details, unpack this announcement and much more. So first of all, George, good to see you again. Tell us about the announcement.
Well, KG, thank you for having me this afternoon and good afternoon to all your viewers. Yes, thanks. This announcement today was, once again, it's quite key, we believe, in the sense that I've set out the timetable for our PEA, which the market's been expecting, and the timetable for that will be the end of September, the beginning of October. We will be releasing our PEA on the Phalaborwa project. The second is that we've done further optimization on our economic flow sheet for the extraction of rare earth elements from the phosphogypsum stacks at Phalaborwa. Now, in June, we made an announcement that we'd successfully developed a flow sheet to economically extract these rare earths. But since then, we've done numerous enhancement steps or optimization steps, I should say. And to give you an example, one of the key steps that we've changed now is that we've gone from nanofiltration with further test work at the KTEC laboratories in America, in Florida. We've gone with the countercurrent leach circuit for leaching our gypsum in solution. This results in a higher recirculation of our sulfuric acid, and it also enables our pregnant leach solution to be to go downstream, to be in a reduced stream. We get a higher loading in the pregnant leach solution, resulting in lower flows to our downstream continuous ion exchange and continuous ion chromatography section of the plant, which is the KTEC section of our plant. But the fact that we have reduced our streams going downstream to the KTEC section of our plant, we are able to have a small equipment sizing, which reduces our CapEx and our OpEx for the overall project. And this was important to get this into the PEA so we can give a robust PEA to the market at the end of September, as I've mentioned.
And George, what does the continued optimization of the flow sheet mean?
It means that, all process plants are continuously optimized through the various stages of study. In other words, we'll continue optimizing in our pre-feasibility stage as well as our bankable feasibility stage. Our team at Rainbow has got quite a lot of experience in designing and building process plants in the mining industry. Our technical director, Dave Dodd, was involved in, he's with Rainbow, was involved in the design. And when we built the Teresa chromite and platinum project in South Africa, this was a unique design at the time. It had never been built before, where we took chromite and the platinum out of the same ore body. And this plant was successfully built by MDM Engineering, which we were both at. And very importantly, during the construction of this plant, we had to add a secondary and tertiary crushing circuit because even at that late stage, test work showed that this would improve the recovery. So we went and optimized the construction, and we built a secondary and tertiary crushing plant. As I said, this is quite normal for projects that we see development all the way through, even into a bankable stage.
And maybe tell us a bit more about your experience and the experience of the team as well, George.
Well, as I've just mentioned that, we've got a lot of experience in building process plants throughout Africa. We've built a number of plants and also offshore. And a large part of that team that was at MDM with myself, we are together at Rainbow. And we believe we've got the experience we've done it before. We've designed and constructed numerous plants throughout Africa.
All right.
And we believe this will be key, obviously, for delivering the Phalaborwa project.
Okay. And we spoke yesterday about the agreement with OCP. They're a Moroccan state-owned phosphate products producer. Maybe remind us of that announcement, if you would, George.
Yes, we feel this is also a very significant announcement for Rainbow. There are two key sources of phosphate deposits around the world, being igneous carbonatite or marine sedimentary deposits. And the IP developed by Rainbow and enhanced with the KTEC agreement we signed last year is specifically applicable to the igneous carbonatite sources of phosphogypsum that we have at our Phalaborwa project. The agreement with OCP and UMP6, which is their research university in Morocco, announced yesterday, is aimed at targeting the rare earths and the marine sedimentary deposits that OCP have in Morocco. And we believe that with the Rainbow and the KTEC IP that we've developed in conjunction with OCP and UMP6's research that they've done to date, we will be able to jointly develop a successful extraction flow sheet for these resources in Morocco with that OCP hold.
All right, George, we'll leave it there. Thank you so much for jumping on again the second time this week. That's George Bennett there from Rainbow Rare Earths.